Question 32, we're also finding the solution on the interval. This is probably the hardest of them all. We actually are going to have to use an identity. It's going to give us a quadratic equation. We're going to need to factor and then solve the quadratic, just kind of like we did in 31, but it was 31 was already factored for us. So we're going to do it here. Noticing cosine squared, and then we've got a sine squared. So we've got something that's squared and something that's not. The only way to do this is to get them both in terms of either sine or cosine, and we're going to have to get them both in terms of sine because we have this Pythagorean identity, which again, I'll point you here. It's up here, sine squared plus cosine. So if you subtract sine squared, you'll get a value for cosine squared is equal to 1 minus sine squared. That's what we're going to use. So we use this identity that cosine squared x is equal to 1 minus sine squared x. And what we're going to do is we're going to substitute 1 minus sine squared for the cosine squared. So again, I'll start off from the beginning. This is the equation we're given, sine x equals minus cosine squared x minus 1. So we're going to make this substitution right here for cosine squared, right? Because this is cosine squared is the same thing as this. So then we've got sine x equals, and again, I kind of like to have my inputs in parentheses, minus 1 minus sine squared x. These are the same thing, minus 1. Now that I see I've got a quadratic, so I'm going to distribute the negative sign through. So this is going to give me a negative 1 plus sine squared x minus 1. Minus 1 and minus 1, those are going to combine. While I'm at it, let me do a little, I want to get this equal to 0 because I see I'm going to have a quadratic. And the only ways to really, the major way of solving quadratics is get it equal to 0. So I'm going to subtract the sine x from both sides, and we're going to combine that at the same time. So minus sine x. Can't subtract sine squared from sine. No, you can't do that. So on this, the left side, we end up with 0. Negative 1 and negative 1 is negative 2, so we do that. I'm going to move the sine squared to the front, and then we've got this minus sine x down here. Now we start to think, how can we factor this? Well, it's a quadratic, so we look for a binomial. The first term is sine squared, so that looks like I could do that with a sine x times sine x. Okay, so when I FOIL this out, I'm going to get sine squared. How do I get negative 2? Well, I either have 2 times 1 or 1 times 2. This negative tells me 1 has to be negative, 1 has to be positive. That's the only way you can get a negative when you multiply. Since the center term is negative, like a negative 1, tells me that the bigger one has to be negative. This would have to be positive. So 1 times negative 2, that gives us the negative 2. We're going to get sine x, a positive sine x, and a negative 2 sine x. When you add those together, you get a minus 1, minus sine x. So this factoring works. Okay. Sorry, it's kind of... That's why I kind of like to use theta when we're doing... But this is x, okay? So we do the same thing we've done before. Two things multiply to give us 0. So either sine x plus 1 equals 0, or sine x minus 2 equals 0. So we subtract 1 from both sides. Oops. And we end up with sine x equals negative 1. Where does that happen? One place exactly. Think about the unit circle down here at the south pole. the y value is negative, is actually negative 1. So that is 3 pi over 2 from your unit circle. Again, since we're right here, we'll go ahead and the y value is negative 1, only at one place, 3 pi over 2. Over here, we add 2 to both sides. And we get that sine x equals 2. Well, let's look that up on the unit circle. Where is the y value equal to 2? Well, here it's equal to 0. Here it's equal to 1. But then it gets smaller again and then back down to 0. There is no place on the unit circle where sine is going to be 2. It's impossible. It just does not exist. There is no solution. Okay, but we do have one. So again, sometimes we get more than one, sometimes we don't. There's only one place this will occur. And that's the one place here. And a lot of times that happens when you're on one of the poles. Okay, it's only one place.